Start with the system off and unplugged. Remove the two screws securing the rear panel. Remove the rear cover by leaning out from the top and lifting up. Disconnect the ground cable from the rear panel. Remove all cables. Take note of the cable locations and number if needed. Unplug all power cables from the main power supply. Remove the ground cable from the e-box assembly. Remove the ground cables from the main power supply. Remove the two screws securing the e-box to the chassis. Hold the cables to either side and slide the e-box out about 8 inches. Remove all cables from the BEP. Again, note each location. Once all cables have been removed, slide the e-box completely out. Remove all screws securing the e-box cover, 8 in total. Remove the e-box cover by lifting up. Remove the CPP cover by pulling up from both sides. Use the ejector tabs to pull up and remove the CPP. Install the replacement CPP using the guide rails. Use the ejector tabs to lock the CPP in place. Reinstall the CPP cover. Replace the e-box cover. Reinstall the 8 screws to secure the cover. Hold the cables out of the way. Reinstall the e-box into the chassis. Be careful not to crush any cables. Make sure to leave the e-box out about 8 inches. Plug in all cables to the BEP. Make sure USB cables are plugged in to the correct ports. Slide the e-box fully into the chassis. Reinstall the 2 screws to secure the e-box to the chassis. Starting from the left, reinstall all cables to the e-box. Secure the grounding cables to the main power supply. replace the AC power cable to the main power supply. Secure the ground cable to the e-box. Secure all cables neatly in the chassis. Use zip ties if needed. Secure the ground cable to the rear panel. Reinstall the rear panel and secure with the two screws.